Champion Clint Hall of Fame. So let's take the time to dive into C.H. Edwards/Booth's Clint Hall of Fame as a worker, as well as a look into his pedigree, as he is certainly worth covering. Clint is quite possibly the most famous terrier currently living. When we purchased Clint from Booth, it was the purchase that was heard around the world. Many were upset, jealous, and bothered by the fact that we purchased Clint. Terrier men like to complain about how much dogs cost or how the next man spend their money. At the end of the day, we value good dogs more than we value money. Clint was not a dog that we needed, as we already had world-class dogs in our kennels. The purchase of Clint was done to make a statement. And that statement is, we do not have the same limitations as the next man. We can do what we want and what many others wish they could do but simply can't. And there is nothing they can do about it other than continue to make up lies and stories about us. Which is weak no matter how you measure it. Clint is a dog that has accomplished everything that a Patterdale Terrier can accomplish. He has successfully worked every form of earth quarry a terrier can work. When it comes to work, there is nothing this amazing dog has not seen. He's produced workers on both sides of the pond in several different countries. His offspring have worked every kind of earth quarry one can mention, and his offspring have been worked by some very well-noted people, such as the great Brian Nuttall's son. And Clint has been given the field champion title by the PTCA and has made the Hall of Fame list. Then to top it off, has been said to be the best looking Patterdale that Booth has ever laid eyes on. Clint was bred by and born on the yard of Mr. Edwards. He spent the early years of his career being dug to by Mr. Edwards. I can recall traveling to Portugal to pick up Oris, which is a dog we will cover in another video. But while we were in Portugal with RS and G's, the conversation of Booth came up. Which led to the conversation of Edwards/Booth's Clint dog, as we said, he is quite possibly the most famous terrier currently living. The first thing that RS said was, Booth's current stud dog is a dog that was bred by Mr. Edwards, and Mr. Edwards' dogs are simply amazing. Many other terrier men have used the hard work of Mr. Edwards to fill their kennels with solid digging dogs. Kennels such as Monster Kennels and others have dogs that come from Mr. Edwards. Edwards is known to be very hard on his terriers. He is known for digging frequently and not giving any excuses for his dogs. Furthermore, he is known to be very honest. If you are like us in that we believe it is best to bet with the man, not the dog, then Mr. Edwards is a guaranteed win. No one that has seen Clint work has ever fixed their mouths to say something negative about him. However, there are men that have never laid eyes on Clint that have spread rumors about him. Which is common within the terriers. When we asked Mr. Edwards about these rumors, he said it is very simple. Ask them if they ever dug to Clint. They will have to say they did not, and that being the case, nothing they have to say holds any weight. After Clint was worked for several seasons by Mr. Edwards, Clint suffered a major injury and was not able to continue to work heavier quarry due to this injury. This injury happened because another man let his terrier enter when Clint was being dug too. This is another reason why you are not supposed to enter multiple dogs in one set. Anytime you see someone letting more than one dog in a hole, you are looking as subpar dogs and a man that doesn't know the first thing about terrier work. It was at this time that Mr. Booth asked to use Clint as his stud dog, to which Mr. Edwards gladly allowed. After Booth obtained Clint, he also dug to him. And then started using him over the top of some of his bitches. Later, when we go over Clint's pedigree, you will see why Booth hand-selected Clint to be the dog to address the lack of hunt drive that has been seen in some of the Booth dogs that are in the States. This is something that American Terrier men created through poor breeding practices and lack of digging their dogs. No fault of Booth's. While Clint is a strong dog that is more suited to work in the UK due to his size, however, Clint has produced quite a few offspring that are ideal size for American earth work. One of the things we noticed is that Clint's offspring tend to be some of the most athletic dogs we've seen in terriers. We have a male that is off of Clint and our bitch named Candy that we call Shiesty, that is a particularly nice male. And Katoop Kennels also has a very nice male off of him that they call Flint, that is proving to be a high drive worker. We utilize Clint to cross back and forth with our AC bred dogs, as well as to go back to some of the old Booth blood to help straighten out the issues that American breeders have caused in the blood. So let's talk about his pedigree for a moment. Clint is off of the Great Simon Dog and is also line bred on the Simon Dog that you will see while covering the pedigree of Champion Clint Hall of Fame. Simon was an excellent worker and producer. He was a strong black dog that was worked thoroughly by Mr. Edwards. Simon was a superb badger and fox dog that succeeded in difficult conditions. Simon was a half Pickax/Jones dog and a half Nuttall dog. However, he could be considered to be a first-generation Schwab bred dog. Simon was off of the infamous Grom/Tom dog, who was bred by Jones of Pickax. This dog is a very controversial figure in the breed, in part due to who his breeder is and then furthermore due to who his owner was. It seems whenever a man is willing to let other buy pups, they immediately become a topic of conversation, hate and stories. Simon was out of Ann Busty, which is another Hall of Fame dog that has made a major impact on the breed as a whole all around the world. She was a red dog that has produced workers on both sides of the pond, as they say. Kennels like monsters, Patterdale House dogs that come down from this bitch. You can also find this blood in Mr. Gill's yard, which would have come from the Jagger brothers initially. We hope to help them get back to some of this blood through the Clint and some bitches that Mr. Gill still owns. Grom was off of the Jones Chaz dog, which is a famous producer and worker alike, and he was out of Jones Tilly, another famous producer and worker. Chaz was in turn off of Jones Ban and out of Jones Raven, which both go back to dogs that are the product to Jones breeding efforts. And Busty was off of Schwab's Nero and out of Schwab's Nike. Both of these dogs were offspring of the Schwab's Digger dog, which is a dog that Schwab seemed to be particularly fond of, which went back to Nuttall Carnish and Nuttall Twiggy. But Nero was out of Schwab's Trog, while Nike was out of Schwab's Shoko, which both go back to all Nuttall dogs. This makes Simon a half Nuttall/Schwab, half Jones/Pickax battle cross. Clint was out of Edwards Tory, which is a well-respected worker and producer. Tory is what ties Clint in so well to click with old Booth dogs. Tory was out of Booth's Caesar. Caesar was a half-brother to Clint, being out of the Simon dog, but Caesar was out of the great Booth's Guinness dog, who was off of Nick Sheedy's Choke and out of the world-class Booth's Tonic Bitch. Tory was out of SPK's Prima Donna, who was a daughter of the great Booth's Bruiser 2 dog, a dog that is respected for his depth of gameness, while she was out of Schwab's Kaya. Bruiser was a son of Joseph Zack and out of Booth's Miss Cracker Zack, being off of Booth Guria and out of a bitch named Karen. Prima Donna's Dam Kaya was also a half-sister to Clint's father, being off of Grom but out of Nike, making her bred similar to the great Simon dog. So in Clint you have a wonderful blend that has been proven to work well in the hands of serious hunters like Mr. Edwards, and have proven around the world to produce great working terriers in the hands of many. Obviously we are proud to say that 3XO is the home of such a great terrier that is both a great producer and worker himself. It was interesting to see the hate when we bought Clint. As we said, the purchase of Clint was the purchase that was heard around the world. We recall some terrier men saying, "You will never dig to that dog because you paid so much for him." I remember laughing at the comment, thinking that makes no sense if you have a winner's mentality. Maybe if you have a poor man's mentality, but not if you are anything like us. To us, this would like buying a $100,000 sports car and never driving fast in it. Being we paid what we paid, we certainly wanted to see with our own eyes what quality of a dog we purchased. Surely once Clint made his way to the States, we took him and dug to him multiple times, and to say that we were satisfied would be an understatement. Clint is everything Mr. Edwards and Mr. Booth said he was. And it is clear that the haters never laid eyes on him when he was working. Well guys, until next time, just remember, a terrier that isn't doing its job from start to finish is one that wouldn't meet our standards, and while others may hate, they can't stop our movement. Much love from everyone in the 3XO camp. Keep digging.